Hello children, welcome to the new module. So now we studied about the inauguration. On the day of the inauguration, Nelson Mandela was very much overwhelmed, filled with a sense of history. He was remembering his past. So before he was born and just after the Anglo-Boer War, that is the first decade of the 20th century, the white-skinned people of Africa, they patched up the differences in the skin color and they showed out the racial discrimination. So that structure they created that formed the basis of one of the cruelest, very most cruel, most inhumane societies the world has ever known. So the world has never seen such an inhumane, such a cruel society. South Africa, the white-skinned people of South Africa had created such a one of the most inhumane societies the world had ever known. But now the last decade of the 20th century has come, and my own eighth decade as a man, that means his 80th year, that is he is in his 80s, and that time that system that had been overturned, and now what has happened, that system has been replaced by one that recognized the rights and freedom of all peoples regardless of the color of their skin. Now, the last decade of the 20th century and my own decade, that is 8th decade, it is now I am more than 80 years old. Okay, and now what had happened, that system has been overturned and now all the people have the same rights and freedoms regardless of the color of their skin. So, that day had come about through the unimaginable sacrifices of thousands of my people. So it did not come out simply. Many people, thousands of people had sacrificed. Unimaginable sacrifices they have done. That day, Nelson Mandela felt that their suffering and courage can never be counted or it cannot be repaid. He felt that day, as I have on many other days, that I was simply the sum of all those African patriots who had gone before me. So he felt that he was the sum of all the African patriots. Who is a patriot? One who dies for the country, one who serves the country. So like that, I am the sum of all the African patriots who had gone before me. That long and noble line entered and now began again with me. I was pained that I was not able to thank them and that they were not able to see what their sacrifices had brought. See, many people sacrifice many things. Only some of them live to see what their sacrifice had gained. But many people died without seeing the fruit of their sacrifice. The policy of apartheid created a deep and lasting wound in my country, and people said that was such a cruel system. So the wound that created in his country and his people, that was very deep and it was a lasting wound. So he says that all of us will spend many years, if not generations, recovering from that profound hurt. Okay, the deep hurt, the profound hurt, it will take many years to recover from that wound, if not generations. The policy of apartheid had created a deep and profound hurt. But it also created another unintended effect. And what was that unintended effect? It produced the Oliver Tambos, Walter Sisulu's, Chief Luthuli's, Yusuf Dadus, Bram Fischer's, and Robert Sobukwe's. These men of such extraordinary courage, wisdom, and generosity, that their like may never be known again. That means we cannot find such great men again. So Nelson Mandela says that it requires such depths of oppression to create such heights of character. So if you want to reach such height of character, we must be oppressed in such a way. And one important thing that Nelson Mandela says about his people are that they are the greatest wealth of Africa. He says that maybe his country is rich in the minerals and gems that lie beneath its soil, but his people are the precious of all. Now this paragraph contains some of the very beautiful words told by Nelson Mandela. So he says that it is from these comrades in the struggle that he had learned the meaning of courage. Actually, he had thought that courage means the absence of fear. But he says that What he has learned from these comrades is that courage is not the absence of fear, but the triumph over it. For being courageous, you must have a fear, and you have to overcome that fear. And he says that the brave man is not he who does not feel afraid, but he must feel afraid and he must conquer that fear. This paragraph also shares very important facts. He says that no one is born hating another person because of the skin of his color or his background or his religion. Are we hating some person because he is a Muslim or a Christian or a Hindu or anything like that? No. People must learn to hate, and if they can learn to hate, they can be taught to love. We are teaching the people to hate. We are teaching the people to love. So if we can teach the people to hate, we can teach the people also to love. For he says that love comes more naturally to the human heart than its opposite. We can easily love other people than hating other people. Even in the grimmest times in prison, when my comrades and me were pushed to our limits, I would see a glimmer of humanity in one of the guards, perhaps just for a second, but it was enough to reassure me and keep me going. So what does he say? He says that even in the most tough times, one spark in the eyes of one of the guards for just a few seconds had kept him going with his life. So that is enough. And he says that man's goodness is a flame that can be hidden but never extinguished. Okay, you can hide the flame for some time, but can we extinguish? Can we blow out that flame? No. Man's goodness is a flame. We can hide that flame for some time. We cannot put out that flame forever. It cannot be extinguished. So in each and every man, there lies some goodness. I hope you understood this module. Thank you.